new thing, facing new thing. There is a innate biological concept which has a very significant role, and the concept is that in the adolescent, there is a stage where the brain undergoes a lot of physiological changes. There is this process in the brain which is called as the pruning of the brain, where the brain is maturing. Just imagine a new skyscraper building is being built. In the process, multiple people are working on it. The developer, the engineer, the architects, etc., etc. There are a lot of people who are working on building a building. Is that building more vulnerable to damages if there is an earthquake? Or a building which is completely well built, stabilized, occupied by resident, is that more vulnerable to damage? Definitely the one which is in the process of building. A very similar pattern is seen in the adolescent brain, and that is why the vulnerability to any stressor in life has a role to play, and anxiety, all mental health issues, adolescents are more vulnerable than most of the other population. With individuals with anxiety, they usually can't stop thinking about situations that come in their life. All of us face anxiety issues practically at some point of the day, almost every day. These children, they tend to get stuck on their worried thoughts. These worried thoughts are usually irrational. They have a very difficult time dealing their normal day-to-day life, normal day-to-day activities. All the anxiety-related problems have four very important aspects. What are they? Anxiety is an inexpressible fear or a preoccupation that develops, which interferes with the ability to enjoy normal life. The anxiety is often puzzling for the child, for the adolescent, as well as the parent. Anxiety does not respond or diminish after logical explanation. So people who worry that it started raining, I hope it does not flood. All the friends around keep telling you that it's not raining so heavy, it may not flood. A very logical explanation. But the moment the thought has become an irrational, intrusive one, whatever amount of explanation that you put into picture, you are not able to overcome the thought. That is why a lot of times in clinical practice we see, we try and initiate a lot of therapy, we try and initiate a lot of counseling, a lot of supportive therapy, but we experience a lot of failures. Specifically, if it's not done in the right way, if it's not handled in the right way, only attempting to counsel, which happens in college children, one friend expresses anxiousness, a group of 10 people surround them, everyone trying to help, counsel, it does not work. Okay, because these thoughts sometimes are very, very rigid. And the anxiety, but always remember, anxiety related issues can be helped. You should never ever say that my anxiety is not treatable, I'm not able to overcome, nothing can help me. Anybody can tell me what are the types of anxiety disorders if I can quickly run through? Anyone? Yes? Generalized, okay. Social anxiety? PTSD, very good. Anybody else want to add anything? Yes? Yes? Somebody?
Depression, yes? Anxiety?
Okay. Anybody on top? Yes? Agoraphobia? Okay. Anyone else? Yes?
Kleptomania.
Kleptomania, okay, comes under the anxiety spectrum.
Phobias.
Pardon?
Any kind of phobia.
Phobias, okay. Good, you all know your stuff. Anybody else?
Separation anxiety.
OCD. Yes. OCD, okay. Okay, we are getting into a bigger spectrum. But yes, all come under anxiety disorders only. When you look at specific anxiety disorders per se, yes, all the specific phobias somebody mentioned, social anxiety, generalized anxiety, panic disorder, agoraphobia, you all forgot separation anxiety. That is one of the anxiety components that are seen at the earliest age. Can anyone tell me at what age does separation anxiety begin? Childhood, what age?